Greetings, I'm Shad, and you might not know, well, you might know, we'll find out. Anyway, you might not know that I can actually draw. When I say draw, I mean like, you know, draw comic book superhero characters, design castles, 3D model, and other things like that. I can actually do that stuff to a, I would consider myself comparable. Or a professional level standard. I'll let you be the judge of where I'm at in terms of my skill. Now, this might make sense to those of you who know who my brother is, Jazza, the famous Jazza from Draw with Jazza. And you might consider that it runs in the family. To some extent, it does, it doesn't. It's not to say that both my brother and myself have not had to practice for many, many years to be able to get to the level that we're at. And that is not to say in any way, shape, or form that there are not better artists out there. I know there are. There are flipping awesome, phenomenal artists that blow me out of the water, okay? And they blow my brother out of the water as well. There are just some incredible artists out there. But that's not to say that Jazza or myself are terrible. I think we've developed a decent level of skill. But the thing about it is that though, yes, we're brothers, and so are there some genetic things that we might get to inherit that helps us along the way? I say yes, but I really want to stress how much work it has taken to get to the level that we're at. And indeed, there are many things that Jazza is better than I'm at. And it takes work and practice. Just you practice your guts out, because it's in practice that you develop skill, talents, and other things like that. Even if you might have a, you know, a genetic inkling towards that kind of craft. And I say that because our grandfather was skilled in sketching. Like he could just do, you know, little simple sketches of people, but he was generally better than the average person. And our father, he paints, is a bit of an artist as well, and he's an architect. And so that certainly runs in the family in that regard. Our older sister is generally fairly good when it comes to artwork in general. And she was considered good for her age, but then she kind of stopped the practice and her skill levels remained the same for that age. And so you wouldn't consider that to be professional standard anymore. And the rest in our family, no, they do not consider themselves, artistically inclined in the sense that they can produce comparable works of art. And they wouldn't consider themselves very artistically inclined. And so if it was purely a genetic thing, everyone in our family would just be talented at it. No, it takes work and practice. And so the reason why I'm doing this video is just to let you, whoever my viewers or my subscribers, know that if you would like to see some of my artwork, it is all available on my DeviantArt page. And indeed, there's a link to my DeviantArt page on the main, you know, I Am Shad channel page. If you look at the I Am Shad logo, just down in the corner over that side, you will see DeviantArt. And so please feel free to go and check that out and enjoy my art if you find it enjoyable. So a little bit about my history with art and drawing in general. First interesting bit of information is, yes, I can draw, okay? But I don't enjoy it. Now that might strike you as rather odd. I have certainly done a lot of it throughout my life to practice and get better and better, and I have gotten far better than I used to be as a kid. Far, far better. Okay, and so that takes a lot of practice. So how did I get this, you know, get to the level I'm at if I don't enjoy it? The answer is yes, it's true. I actually don't enjoy the act of drawing. What I enjoy is what I'm drawing. So the genre, the, you know, that's specifically. And see, that's interesting because you see, all my life I have created stories. So in that sense, I am a natural storyteller. If there's something that I enjoy just doing, it's creating stories, characters, and other things like that. That's why I'm doing my very best to become an author, a writer, because that's what I love doing. And that has been the central ingrained kind of, you know, thing of who do I consider I am? I consider myself a storyteller. It's another reason why I love role-playing games. But you see, I did not like English. Indeed, growing up, I was very, very bad at English. This is a true story. I almost got kept down in grade 6 because I was so bad at spelling. And so with that in mind, you can kind of understand why I was not really a big reader, or I didn't like books or novels at all because of that. And so I was never going to express these stories that I loved to create in a literary form. No, not at all. The way that I expressed it was through drawing. You see, that was the expression. I would create these stories, these characters, and I would want to bring them a little bit more into reality. And the way that I did that is that I would draw them. And that is literally how I drew so much. And I did draw a lot, but it was all about these characters that I was making. And I got heaps of art stocked up throughout the years of these things that I drew over the years. Now, this did indeed lead me to believe when I was younger that I was a natural born artist in the sense that I loved drawing. And so that's the career that I wanted to do. I wanted to be a comic book artist. I wanted to draw Spider-Man and other things like that. And I have drawn Spider-Man quite a lot throughout the years. He was my favorite comic book superhero growing up. But something did not really, like, I experienced something that I didn't really understand until I was older, and that's when other people asked me to draw something for them, like commissions and stuff like that. Someone would ask me to draw them as a person, and I found it very hard to complete those projects just because I didn't find it interesting and I wasn't enjoying drawing it. But I didn't click. To me, I still enjoy drawing, but I just had so much trouble doing these commission pieces and things like that. But things didn't click as to why that was the case until later on. And so I continued drawing, when I say drawing, you have to remember the amount of drawing, all the art that I ever did was really just an expression of the storyteller side of myself. That's the natural side thing that comes very naturally to me. And so I continued making stories, and then I would draw those characters. And as I did that, my talent would progress. All the while, I wasn't really realizing that's why I was doing it. I was thinking, I'm going to be a comic book artist and draw Spider-Man for a living, make my own comic books. It was only until later in life that I actually discovered that I enjoyed writing a bit. If you know anything about me through my, YouTube channel, you know that I'm interested in many different things, science and other stuff, and so I do research in the things that I do. And in part of my research, when I'm trying to learn things, sometimes I write papers on them purely for my own interests. Like, literally, sometimes I might write papers on how I understand a scientific principle and how that might apply in a cool new way. It's just my research process. But when I started to do that, I discovered something. I enjoyed writing, and this was a shock to me, because up at this point I did start reading, and I was reading fantasy books, and I was enjoying them and stuff like that, but I was still bad at spelling. But I discovered I enjoyed the act of writing if I was interested in what I was writing. This very same thing that led me to believe I enjoyed drawing, because it wasn't the act of drawing, just like it isn't the act of writing, that I enjoyed. It was the genre, the medium of what I was actually doing. And so if I was interested in the thing that I was writing, just like if I was interested in the thing that I was drawing, I could do a lot of it. This was a fairly new discovery for me, but it didn't lead me to the ultimate conclusion that I didn't enjoy the act of drawing. I still thought I wanted to be a comic book artist. And up at this point, all of this was with the stories I was making. And so I had crafted this big, classic fantasy story that I was very determined to make into a comic book. Indeed, you can go to my DeviantArt page and go to one of the later pages in the gallery, and you will find a comic book page spread of panels of the early concepts of this fantasy comic book that I wanted to make. But in making those panels, I found it to be extremely tedious and labor-inducive and stuff, because not every panel you draw is interesting. It's not of a cool character doing a cool thing. Sometimes it's just a scene of a city or a road or a peasant on a road, because that's the storytelling thing. And I found it very, very tedious. And this was when I started to discover that maybe it's not the drawing I'm enjoying. Maybe it's specifically drawing the characters. And good time to find out, because I just spent a lifetime trying to develop this talent. My DeviantArt page should be testament to, the amount of time that I have put into developing that skill. But luckily, I was also developing my ability to create stories in the same process. And ultimately, when I decided I was sitting down, that I wanted to create this story, I realized that to make a comic, I would need to write out the whole thing, essentially. And yes and no, it's mainly in dialogue, but I'd be writing out the whole story anyway, I felt. And then I'd just have to draw it all in the same time. And I figured, well, I could cut my work in half and just write the story. And that's when I really kind of discovered and found out that it's not the drawing I enjoy, it's the story. And so my life goal kind of shifted. Well, it didn't really shift because I still wanted to create a story. It's just the medium that I was doing it in changed. Comic books, and who knows, maybe in the future, but I would not have the time or patience to draw it myself. I'd need to hire a different artist. I could do the character design. See, that's what I love designing, you know, the visual look of things, because I am still a very visual person. And so when it comes to, you know, design, how things look, I really like to have the artistic control of that. That's the thing, you know. I love creating these stories, bringing them into greater reality. And when I brought them into visual reality, I wanted to bring them into visual reality my way. I wanted them to look the way I envisioned them to look. And so if I ever do a comic book, something down the future, I would be designing everything, no worries, but I would not be drawing a whole thing because it should be way too tedious. And so, yes, I still made stories, but just the medium shifted. Now it was in writing, and that started me on a whole new another adventure of developing skill as a writer, and that's the one I'm still on. Been working at it a while, and I've gotten a lot better. I can, you know, testify to the truth of practice makes perfect. I don't think I'm perfect, and I don't think I might ever be perfect, but it certainly makes you better because I can see what my skill level, my quality was like before and after working at it, and there is a huge amount of improvement. So I feel, yes, I can testify as a living example of the use and benefit of practice in art and now in literature, in writing. And so there's a bit of a story for you. I hope you enjoyed. And so feel free to go to my DeviantArt page and have a look at my art. And because I still do find myself drawing on the odd occasion, even now when I discovered, after a lifetime, that I don't really enjoy the drawing, but I still enjoy bringing my creations into a visual form of reality. And so feel free to check out my art. And, you know, it's funny, like, I do not consider myself a career artist. I'll never do it as a career. I couldn't do it. I just don't enjoy it. But it's not to say that I'll stop drawing. I still make things. And I might do a tutorial here and there because I have developed, you know, skill in it. I've practiced a lot at it and I've gotten, you know, better at it over the years. And so, I'm not going to be doing what my brother does, like draw with Jazza, but you know, I might be doing little tutorials and things I'm interested in, like how to draw a sword in proper, you know, form, function, and proportion, and other things like that. And just, you know, maybe you might appreciate my own process because I have developed a process because I have worked on it for quite a while over the years. And so, yes, feel free to enjoy my art if you want to visit my DeviantArt page. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for letting me ramble on, giving you a bit of a background, a bit of history about where that side of myself comes from. And until next time, enjoy.